Indian military consists of three professional uniformed services: the Indian Army, Indian Navy, and Indian Air Force. Additionally, the Indian Armed Forces are supported by the Indian Coast Guard and paramilitary organizations and various inter-service commands and institutions such as the Strategic Forces Command, the Andaman and Nicobar Command, and the Integrated Defense Staff. The President of India is the Supreme Commander of the Indian Armed Forces. For 2021, India is ranked 4th out of the 140 countries considered for the annual Global Firepower Review. India has a total population of 1,326,000,000 and is the second most populous country in the world. As of 2021, Indian Armed Forces active personnel stands at 1,445,000. The country's Air Force has a total aircraft strength of 2,119, of which 542 are fighter jets, 775 are helicopters, and 37 are attack helicopters. Currently, Sukhoi Su-30 is the main fighter aircraft of the Indian Air Force with 272 jets in active service. India also operates 23 Dassault Rafale multi-role fighters with 12 more on order, 69 MiG-29s, 34 indigenous HAL Tejas fighters out of 103 ordered, and 49 Mirage 2000s. India also operates 108 MiG-21 interceptor aircraft, which will be retired by 2025. Indian Air Force has a transport aircraft fleet of a total of 251 aircraft consisting of Ilyushin IL-76, Antonov An-32, Boeing C-17, 777, 737 and Dornier 228. HAL Tejas is the indigenous fourth-generation multi-role light fighter designed and manufactured by India. Indian Air Force planned for a total of 324 Tejas in several variants. The Tejas Mark II is expected to be ready for serial production by 2025. India operates Russian Mi-24 and American AH-60 for Apache attack helicopters. Indigenous HAL Light Combat Helicopter is in mass production and 8 units are delivered out of plan 65. HAL Dhruv is India's own utility helicopter and is in service since 2002. Approximately 300 units have been built so far. Also total 94 HAL Chetak and Cheetah helicopters are license-built light utility helicopters of Indian Air Force. 6 Soviet Il-78 aircraft equipped with Israeli fuel transfer system make up the tanker fleet. Indian Air Force is ranked 4th in the world in terms of number of total and fighter aircraft, behind United States, Russia and China. Indian Army is the largest branch of the Indian Armed Forces with 1,327,117 active personnel and 960,000 reserve personnel. Army operates a total of 4,730 tanks. Largest part of the main battle tanks are Soviet T-72s and Russian T-90s. The Army has 124 Arjun Mark I main battle tanks in service. Development of the Arjun Mark II, an advanced third-generation main battle tank, is completed and is under evaluation by the Indian Army. Approximately 10,000 armored vehicles, 100 self-propelled and 4,000 towed artillery, as well as 374 rocket projectors, make up the remaining inventory of the Army. Armored vehicles are mostly of Soviet and Indian origin and make up about half of the total Army inventory. Indian Army ranks 4th in the world in number of tanks. Its biggest regional rival, China, operates 3,205 tanks and ranks 8th. Indian Navy operates a total of 285 warships. Navy fleet strength, taking account of all surface and underwater elements, ranks well below its rivals. At 9th place, India is one of a handful of countries that operate aircraft carriers, with INS Vikrant in service, and INS Vikrant expected to be commissioned in 2022 with recent delays due to COVID-19 pandemic. INS Vikrant is the first indigenous aircraft carrier of India, constructed by Cochin Shipyard in Kochi. Indian Navy also has plans for a third aircraft carrier. Indian Navy has approximately 68,000 active and 55,000 reserve personnel and operates 300 aircraft. Akula II-class and Arihant-class submarines are nuclear-powered. Arihant-class ships have ballistic missile launch capability. Currently, for Arihant-class submarines are planned 2 already completed and 2 under construction. Third and fourth ships of this class will have 2 times more ballistic missile launch capacity than the first batch of ships. A new class of SSBNs with codename S5 is also planned that will be able to carry 12 to 16 long-range ballistic missiles. India has 10 destroyers, of which 6 are Kolkata and Delhi-class guided missile destroyers and constructed locally. Out of 13 frigates India operates, 3 Shivalik-class ships are stealth-guided missile frigates and are commissioned in 2012. Its follow-on Nilgiri-class frigates are projected to be the principal frigates of the Indian Navy in 21st century. 7 Nilgiri-class frigates are ordered and currently under construction. First ship of this class is expected to be commissioned in August 2022. India has a large fleet of patrol vessels due to its long 7,000 kilometers shoreline, being in the center of shipping lines and housing major trade ports in the Indian Ocean. Defense budget of India stands at $73,650,000,000, making it the third country in the world after United States and China. In 1992, India signed the Chemical Weapons Convention, stating that it did not have chemical weapons or the capacity or capability to manufacture them. India informed the United Nations in May 2009 that it had destroyed its stockpile of chemical weapons in compliance with the International Chemical Weapons Convention. India has been in possession of nuclear weapons since 1974. India's nuclear missiles include the Prithvi, the Agni, the Shorya, the Sagarika, the Danish, and others. With its 5,000 kilometers range, the Agni 5 can carry a nuclear warhead to the east to include all of China, and to the west deep into Europe. Agni 6, with a perceived range of 6,000 to 8,000 kilometers, is also under development. India also has bomber aircraft such as the Tupolev Tu-142, as well as fighter jets like the Dassault Rafale, Sukhoi Su-30 MKI, the Dassault Mirage 2000, the MiG-29 and the HAL Tejas, capable of being armed with nuclear-tipped bombs and missiles. India can also launch nuclear-armed missiles from its submarines. Since India does not have a nuclear first-use policy against an adversary, it becomes important to protect from a first strike. This protection is being developed in the form of the two-layered anti-ballistic missile defense system. It consists of two land and sea-based interceptor missiles, namely the Prithvi air defense missile for high-altitude interception and the advanced air defense missile for lower-altitude interception. In October 2018, India inked an agreement with Russia for $5.4 billion to purchase 5S-400 Triumph surface-to-air missile defense systems. India's future defense programs include directed energy weapons and hypersonic technology demonstrator vehicle. DRDO, Defense Research and Development Organization, has also identified space security, cybersecurity, and hypersonic vehicles and missiles as focus areas in the next 15 years. We hope that you enjoyed watching our video. Please leave a comment and let us know what you wish to see next on our channel. So, just before you move to another video, we have a small request. Please subscribe to our channel and click the bell button to receive notifications of our new videos. Thank you for watching Nick's Defense.